friends, today I'm going to be taking the topic assignment problem from resource management techniques. So what is an assignment problem? So if there are 5 machines, each of the machine has to be allocated with a job. Suppose let's say the 5 machines are M1, M2, M3, M4 and M5. And if the jobs are J1, J2, J3, J4 and J5. So let's say suppose these machines M1, M2, M3, M4 and M5 are there. So the machine 1, let's say, has been assigned with job 3. The machine 2 has been assigned with job 2. This has been assigned with job 4. This has been assigned with job 1. And this one has been assigned with job 5. So this is an ideal case. This should happen, okay, once we solve the problem. Suppose in one step or the other, if any one of the machine has not been allocated with a job, then there are few steps that are to be followed so that that machine also gets allocated to a job, right? So let's proceed to the problem. So when it comes to this assignment problem, here you go, there are machines, okay, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, and there are jobs J1, J2, J3, J4, J5, J6. So the number one rule of this, or the number one step, let's say, okay, so the number one step is the number of rows have to be equal to the number of columns, right? Only then they can be assigned with that particular job, right? So in this, if you see, the number of rows is equal to 5 and the number of columns is equal to 6. So this is not balanced, this is unbalanced, right? So since this is unbalanced, we'll have to add one more row to make it balance. One more row, a dummy row, right? We'll have to add a dummy row. Dummy row is added, okay? Now let's do that, okay? So now I've added the dummy rows, okay, row, okay? So you can see there are zeros, right? Okay. So the next step is, So now the next step is find out the smallest element in each row and subtract this element from all the elements of that respective row. So now let's just find out what is the smallest element in each row. Okay, I'll just write it down. Okay. So I'll just write it down in the side of this table. So in this row, in this particular row, what is the smallest element? The smallest element is 8. Okay. So in this particular row, the smallest element is 10. In this particular row, the smallest element is 3. In this particular row, the smallest element is 6. In this particular row, the smallest element is 7. In this particular row, the smallest element is 0. Okay. Okay. So now we'll have to subtract this element from all the elements of this row, right? Okay, let's do that. So now let's just populate this table, okay? Yeah. So we'll have to subtract 8 from all the elements of the first row. So we'll get 4, 2, 7, 14, 10 and 0. In the next one, we are subtracting 10. So you're getting 0, 8, 15, 5, 6, 2. In the next row, you're subtracting 3. So which is 8, 7, 0, 5, 2, 6, okay? And the next one we are subtracting 6, right? So 0, 8, 4, 7, 7, 6. Yeah, sorry, here I have not written down, right? So 5, 2, 6, yeah. The next row we'll have to subtract 7, so which is 1, 5, 4, 0, 6, 3. And the next one will be 0 itself. Okay? Yeah. Okay, so the step 3 is to find the smallest element. Find the smallest element from each column and subtract that element from all the elements of that column. And subtract that element from all the elements of that particular column. Right. Okay, this is fine. Okay, but in this matrix, when you see, we already have zeros. Like, okay, now let's just examine the same matrix and find out the smallest element from each column. Okay, so I'll write down it on the top of the table. I'll write down the smallest column elements on the top of the table. So here it's very simple because in each column we have zeros, so I'll just write down zeros, so obviously there'll be no change. But if there was any other element, suppose if in this column one was the smallest, then you will have to subtract one from the other elements in that particular column alone. So in this anyway we have no other changes to be performed because the smallest elements from each column is zero itself, so we'll keep this table as it is. Okay, so the next step is you'll have to scan through each row, and if there is only one zero, make a box around it. So scan through each row. Okay, if only one zero, box it, and cut the zeros, in that particular column. Okay. And if there are more than one zeros, then skip. Right. Okay. So now let's do that, right? Okay. Yeah. I'm going to do that. Now let's see. In the first row, if you see, there is exactly one zero. So let's just box that zero. Okay. Then you'll have to cut. What did I tell you? You'll have to cut the zero in that particular column. So we'll do that. In the next row as well, there is only one zero, we'll box it. Okay, we'll box it and cut the zero in that particular column. Again, next row, there's only one zero, we'll box it and cut the zero in that particular column. And then in the next row, we don't have any, so we'll leave it. And in the next one, we'll see that we can find that there's only one zero, so again, so box it and cut it. Okay, cut it. So now we are done. Okay, so in the other one, in the last row, there are three zeros, so we'll skip it. So now the same procedure has to be repeated for the column as well. So step five will be yeah. So if there is scan through each column. So if there is one zero, box it and cancel zeros in that row. More than one zeros, skip. Okay, that's what we are doing. Okay, now let's do that procedure here. Okay, now let's go to the first column. Okay, we'll see that in the first column, I'll also have to cut this. So yeah, okay. Now in the first column, when you see, there are no zeros. One zero is already allocated. And in the second column, when you see, there'll be the zero in this last one, in this last row. So, and then in that particular, so see along that particular row, you'll find out one more zero, just cut it off. Then you'll have to go to the next column. So there's nothing. So the next column, there's nothing. And next column, nothing. And next column, nothing. Okay. So we've got the allocation this way. Yeah. Okay. But the problem is you'll have to continue these steps until the number of boxes is equal to the number of rows. So in this, the number of rows is equal to, here I'm writing it down here. So number of rows is equal to 6. Number of boxes is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so there are only 5 boxes. So since we need, now we need, I mean, why do we need that many? Because we need to allocate jobs for each machine. So we need equal number of boxes, right? So for that, we'll have to do a procedure. Let's do that. Okay, so the next step is you need to put a tick next to the unallocated row, okay? So what is the unallocated row here? It is the 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, fourth row is unallocated. So first let's put a tick around it. Yeah, let's put a tick around it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so we'll have to put a tick here. Okay, we'll put a tick here, right? Then what you need to do is you'll have to see for allocated, we'll have to see for zeros in that row, okay, in that, I mean, we'll have to see for zeros in that particular row. So if you see here, we'll find it out in the first column, okay, you'll have to check for zeros. So in the first column, so put a tick over there, allocated zeros. In unassigned row, we'll have to check for allocated zero in that particular column. So we'll see that, okay. In this, again, go directly to where allocated zero is present and tick that row. Understood. So what have I done? First, I have ticked the unassigned row. After ticking the unassigned row, I've seen where in that particular row, like from that row, I'll have to see where an allocated zero is present and tick that particular column. So you have seen that when you go through that along that row, you will find out that this particular zero has been allocated. So tick that column. In that column, you'll have go along that column and then tick that particular row. So this is what you have done. Okay, so the next step is to you'll have to put a line along the unassigned rows and assigned columns. Okay, I'll have to put that, so let's do that. So I'm going to do this, right? An unassigned row, that is unticked row and ticked columns, that's what I mean when I say this. Okay, okay, so now I've put this, done. Okay, now what you need to do is you'll have to find the smallest element in the entire matrix. So when you see in this whole matrix, you'll find out that 2 is the smallest element. Okay, so in the intersected boxes, in the intersected place, that is where both horizontal and vertical lines are present, you will have to add this small value. Okay, so and in the places where no lines have been drawn, you will have to subtract this 2, and rest of the places, that is like where there is only one single line, there you can leave it as it is, no change. Done. So let me just remind you what I've done. So in the I have just ticked the unassigned rows. Okay, after ticking the unassigned rows, I'll have to check, suppose this was the first unassigned row, right? I have to check in that row where a zero is present. So in that row, in the first, only here the zero is present. So I will tick that particular, only in this part, okay? Only here my zero is present. So my zero is present. So I'll have to tick that particular column. So I'll go in that column, I'll go to the assigned zero and tick that particular row. So that's what I've done here. Nothing else, okay? So as I told you, you'll find out the smallest element and then add it with that intersected part where both the lines are there, and where there is single line, there is no change, and the remaining ones you'll have to subtract this 2 or this smallest element. Okay, so let me do that and show you. So I've written out that table. So how have I done that? So if you see the first element, this 4, right? I'm circling it down here. See this 4, I have added it. I've added it with 2. And here also there is 8, so I've added it with 2. Here also there is 1. I've added it with 2. Okay. So these are, and here there is 0. I've added it with 2 as well. So here you go. Okay. So this is how you get it. Then in these lines, suppose this line, single lined elements, 2, 7, 14, 10, 0 have remained as it is. They have remained as it is. Okay. And in these elements, okay, this 8, 15, I've reduced to 2. So you can clearly observe 6, 13, 3, 4. Okay, so 3, I mean, so 6 minus 2, 4, 2 minus 2, 0. So that's how I've done it. Yeah, so okay. Now again, I'll have to carry out that same allocation process. I mean, scanning through each row, scanning through each column. That's what I need to do right now. Let me just change this color. Okay, yeah, okay. Now I'll have to go through this one. First I'll go to this. Okay, I'll have to go to the first row. I'll scan it. I'll find out that this is the only zero that is present. So I'll cancel out the remaining zeros. And I'll go to the next row. There's only one zero because here this zero has been cancelled. So I'll just allocate this as well. Okay, and assign this as well. So, and I'll cut the zeros in that particular column. Now in the third row, I'll allocate this thing, this zero, and I'll cut this off, right? And the fourth row, there's nothing. In the fifth row, I'll find out that this is there, so then I'll cut it off, right? Okay. And in sixth row there are 2, so we leave it. So next, let's go column by column. This column there is no zero, and the second column you'll find out there is 1 zero, so you'll allocate that zero and you'll cancel out the zero in that particular row. So just go to this, then you'll go to the third column, one is cut and one is assigned, and the fourth column nothing, fifth column nothing, sixth column nothing. So this is what is happening. Okay, now again the same procedure. We'll have to find out if the number of boxes is equal to the number of rows. In this boxes you'll find out that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are 5 boxes only, and there are 6 rows. So again, even this has not helped us. So we'll have to repeat this whole procedure, this finding out the small element and adding and subtracting it. So you'll have to repeat this whole procedure. So that's what I'm going to do right now. So in this, let's see which is the unassigned. This one is unassigned, right? So I'm putting a tick with the red color pen. So yeah, so this one is the unassigned one. You'll have to find out where the zero is. So you found out that this is the you'll find out that this is the the first column is the thing, so you'll have to circle it down, right? Okay. And and then you'll go to this thing again, you'll go up and find out the and tick the row in that particular column. So just do that. Okay. Yeah, so this was the only unassigned one, right? All others have been assigned, I guess. So 1, 2, 3, fourth one only was not assigned. Yeah, correct. Okay, so this is what is happening. Okay, we have done this. Okay, right? I think we have done pretty much everything possible, I guess. I'm not sure though. Yeah, okay, I've done everything. So after proceeding with the same procedure that we've discussed before, we'll be getting this answer. I've not done it again because I've already explained it. So you please try it yourself, and if you have any doubt, please let me know in the comments down below. So here you can just in this you can see that A has been allocated to 2. Okay, so 2 in the sense we are talking about the column. Okay, so A has been allocated. So this was A, B, C, D, E, right? A, B, C, D, E, F, right? So, and this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah. So A has been allocated to 2, B has been allocated to 6, 6 has been allocated to 3, and D has been allocated to 1, and E has been allocated to 4, and F has been allocated to 5. So this is the procedure. Okay, and after this you'll have to calculate the cost. So you'll have to take back the original matrix that you got. So the initial original matrix was this in this place there was 10. So it is 10 plus 12 plus 3 plus 6 plus 7 plus 0. So it is rupees 38, right? So they've asked us to calculate the cost. That is the reason we have to assign the people with the machines, and then you'll have to calculate the cost. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.